So we continue with your done of a big HP nasal jet. I hope to make big progress today. I did notice some stuff to I can do to make progress. So I think we can remove the oven right now quite easily. You can see how this wire is arranged with plastic things, which are, by the way, just clipped in place, like so. So here we have this mechanical contraption, not sure what it does, but it should be a free screws deal, I believe. Last one is here. Yes. So this is an assembly with a bunch of gears. Also, it seems we have a solenoid here, and maybe another one or a clutch or something like this. So this will be examined further later. Now I should be able to remove the oven. I have one screw here, one here. So in fact, you can replace the oven quite easily, but it is a matter of taking stuff apart. Yes, here we are, oven assembly. Not sure if it is the main drum of the oven. If it is, no, there is another one here. But this one seems quite sad, quite weird in fact. Gears on the side, some sensors probably inside on the heating assembly. So this will be probably be teared on itself. What next? I see we have this wall. Oh, one loose gear. We have this, no, it is attached. So the whole frame of this thing is made of a lot of metal parts bolted together. So the next part we can do, I will do this here for the IEC plug. And the oven section. We will also try today to remove some of the plastic bits. Not sure. Obviously it will be. So we can remove now the laser assembly. It is very easy. Four screws for this top piece. Like so. And we have some kind of metal clips you have to unclip. Metal springs or something like this. Like so, little metal pieces that are clipped in the chassis and will allow to remove the whole thing. So there is one plug over here, one flat ribbon here, and last one is here. Okay, and now it is magic. Here is the laser assembly. So as you can see, at the bottom we have four output windows. We have this metal piece in the middle. And we have one PCB. And I can spot here the four, probably the pins, yes, of the laser diodes. So it looks like the four laser diodes are grouped in this middle section. So this will be very interesting to look at in order to see how they did make this. Okay, and surely enough it makes a big hole in the thing. It is still very heavy on this side here. And concerning this side, we can now try to undo the power supply, because previously I was not able to see how to remove it. And in fact, we had three screws hidden here at the bottom, under the plastic frame. So if I can access these screws, one, excuse me, I may be totally in the frame of the camera. Two. They are very deep. Okay. Yes, it seems good. But before I remove this assembly, it looks like I need to undo a few wires. Like all these ones here. So it makes those there's a lot of plugs to undo. And unroute the wires from the plastic frame, plastic assembly. Like so, we have one big wire loom here. This one is hard to remove. Okay, we have one here. This is for the power to the motors, by the way. And a few auxiliary ones here. This is probably power to the processing electronics. And here power to the motors and servo controls and whatnot. Okay. Now we should be good to go. And we will discover what the power supply looks like. Maybe. No. The screw is not easy to reach this one. So, is it coming off or not? Should be nice, in fact. Well, maybe I need to unroute a little more the wires because it looks like it is preventing it to go. Not sure. I don't see any other screw on this side. But this screw here. Excuse me, I was expecting such problems. Yes, this screw is not turning. It looks like. Anywhere because I was able to turn it previously. Okay, let me figure it out and I will be right back. Okay, finally, it's done. The thread is scrapped here. Is not good anymore. So I have one wire loom here and it should come. It should come. Not sure why, does not want today. It is a bad day, obviously. Because I do not see any other screw. In fact, not sure, maybe this one. Oh, it is a little bit better. But it is still prisoner by here somewhere. So I need, it seems, to undo this. This thing is really overcomplicated, guys. Ah yes, there is a metal tab. In fact, you have to lift the power supply. Okay. A few more plugs to undo. And we should be good. So here is the power supply assembly. As you can see, quite a beefy one. We have a gigantic mains capacitor here. Very serious filtering. A bunch of relays. Bunch of transformers are not very big, the transformers. Some voltage regulators. Some caps which are not bulged. They seem to be okay. And the wires which were distributing the power. Here we have this plastic assembly which is clipped in some way. So we will probably have a better look at it later. Let me put this aside. Like so. Okay. So now it makes a good hole at least in the frame. And I think I can start to undo some auxiliary stuff as all the random plastic bits and accessories, for example. So there is this one, not plastic, but it is a power on button. We have here all the plastic bits are easy to remove. In fact, it is just one screw. So here we have a connector for the optional paper tray. Okay. Already a lot of junk to figure out what to do with. Here at the front we have this one assembly. So by the way, there was plastic parts in here, but they did fall. There was a plastic part making contacts with toners. And it did just fall. So I did remove it already. One screw here. And in fact, this wall part now is almost empty. Everything remains stuck here on the right side. So I think. Oh, lots of plastic part flying away. I need to start digging in here now, and this will be a pain. So we have this assembly here. Plastic. Really, there is no shortage of plastic. More plastic with wire going to the oven heater. Okay. What next? We have more parts in here, but it seems very complicated to reach. So it looks like it is time to start digging in this, because now I can maybe unclip this like so. Excuse me, you are not in the frame. And maybe try to undo stuff like this. But we will do the electronics first. Here we have this PCB. This thing is really over complicated, guys. One of the biggest teardowns I have done in the last years, probably. Little auxiliary PCB. We have here what seems to be the motherboard on a tray. So maybe I can undo the wall tray. is the main processing board, at least, probably. Let's try to figure it out. I want to keep metal structure together as long as possible. More plastic. Oh, it just revealed one screw. No, it is not interesting for me for now. I want to undo this tray, but oh, there is one screw at the back. Really, the engineering in these things, oh, it is all calculated all together, and all the parts fit together and such must be quite insane. So they have a long experience because they make it for since many, many years, but still, it is always impressive. So it looks like an intelligent PCB. Motherboard of some description, yes. And now, of course, I have two hidden screws which were located under this motherboard, so this is why it did not want to come, this assembly. Okay, so just basic metal pieces. And I can see a little bit better what we have in here. We will assemble. Oh, it will be maybe interesting for you if you can have a look like so. Do you see? It is a wall mechanism pulling back the shaft for the toner drums. We have four big springs here and a whole bunch of mechanical stuff. So maybe I can undo these motors. Will they come or not? Yes. But then the number for you if you want to research them. Maybe Pena, of course. The other one is the same. As you can see, we have some kind of insulating material here and this plastic piece. Now everything is coming loose. Look at this nice plate here with many holes, and I can see a shaft for the wall gear train inside. Probably over complicated. Okay, I will finish with this area here, because it looks like this wire loom is going to this motor. So there is this PCB. Let's screw. I can't imagine the process for assembling these things. I don't know if it is mainly done by robots or what. The number of parts you have to put together in the right order, it is really a really hard network together. So the networking board here, nice one. It will allow me to remove this plate here. With more screws. Just for this plate, I had 6 or 7 screws. Okay, and now it gives access to the last motor. Grande tumor, plastic parts, which he does just pull out like so. Okay, we have him. Lots of wires going somewhere in there for something. I do not know what. Ah, there is another motor here at the bottom. But for now, I will just undo this one. So either the screws are very tight on this thing, either they are not tight at all, it is quite weird. Of course, there is always one more screw. This is more fun. Okay. Okay. And I have here, let me check. I do not see how to remove it. This plastic assembly here on the last motor. Will it come? No, yes, not sure. No, it is stuck in some way. Ah, okay. Again, here the wire is very complicatedly rooted in this part. Quite a lot of work to do all this probably in the factory. Distributed here to probably sensors and whatnot. I have one last motor here. Probably stepper motor, this one. Yes, Mitsumi stepping motor. Quite a beefy one, it seems. Yes, I have three coils inside. Okay, so we are left with a number of mechanical parts in here, probably a lot of solenoids and stuff. So I do not know what will be the next video. Probably finishing to strip this thing, because I guess it should not be very long, in fact. It is just an unscrewing marathon, probably, but apart from this, it should get in pass quite easily now. Ah, excuse me, it is a dog. So here is what it looks like at this time. Some more stuff hidden here in the bottom, probably, and still the wall. Complicated mechanical assembly in here. Okay, so let me see. Yes, let's do it. It is just a few extra screws. Let's try to undo this thing here. It will probably be very messy with a lot of grease, but I do not even know if it will come easily or not. It seems yes. Well, it is where the most of the weight of the printer is located, by the way, it seems. Quite interesting. This one. Maybe we have an extra one hidden behind here. These plastic parts are really annoying. And yes, extra screw. And here we are. Pretty serious gears, as you can see. With a lot of grease. And here, more gears and more grease. And a lot of stuff which I do not identify. You can see here in the middle of this piece, there is a strap grounded for some reason. I can see a solenoid here. And yes, stuff. So, but this will be for our next video. I think it is good already for today. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.